BotBots. We're back with the BotBots. We have BotBots that have been showing up all over the place. In Canada, they've been showing up all over Toys R Us. In the United States, they've been popping up all over Walmarts. We've had all, I believe at this point, we've had about 60 or 70 released, and we have a pretty good idea of what is available right now. But the Australian Hasbro product page has revealed to us more BotBots. We have the Bakery Bytes, and we have the Lawn League. And no surprise, as I predicted, most of it is just repaints of previous BotBots. There is two new molds here, although the more I look at one of these new molds, I'm actually seeing it's actually a remold. So like, let's just go into some of the repaints. So they took one of the pizza BotBots, and they turned it into a slice of pie, which I think is actually kind of clever.
Very clever.
Some of the other
I was going to say, what they could do is like take that pizza and then make it into like a deep dish pizza. Just
I guess
redo
so.
It.
Well, it was
just repaint
cute
it. That would be another repaint, but it'd be like Chicagoland, and then they make it more Chicago based.
What's cute about it too is they actually like they because the face of the original pizza guy was a flat surface. It gives them an opportunity to paint any kind of expression on it. So it's like a guy that's kind of has like he's chewing on a piece of pie.
Yeah.
So it's pretty cute. A lot of the other ones are just kind of just straight up repaints or mild repaints. Like the chainsaw guy was originally orange. Now he's orange yellow. Now he's kind of a green.
Mm-hmm.
Two of the new molds here. Number one, one of them here that's a new mold is it's like a it's a mixer. It's kind of like a mixer of like pancake mix or cake mix. That's a brand new mold. And the other one here is it's supposed to be a roller pin. But the thing is that anyone who's messed with the BotBot of I think his name was Sup Dog, which was he was the pogo or the corn dog.
Okay.
The engineering is 100% from that. Like the transformation is exactly like it. The way the arms, the way the visor head, even the legs, it's 100%.
Maybe a little bit similar to the Batsy.
Or Batsby.
Batsby,
it's similar to it, but not the same transformation where it's 100% the transformation of the corn dog.
Okay.
So it's, I mean, these are interesting. It's cool that they're hilarious. It shows though, like that the thing that kind of sucks this time around is if you want to get a full set, you have to buy each set multiple times and you end up with a whole bunch of doubles.
Yeah.
And then there's a whole bunch of blind pack stuff that isn't even addressed at all, like what those might be. So then there's all kinds of speculation of what
it might
be. I think
there's another one that's a repaint if you want to go through all of them.
They're all repaints.
Suds,
yeah.
Oh, okay. Suds beard?
Yeah, Suds beard. Like
there's another one like it's white and it has like a little clover leaf on the top.
Same thing with like the dinosaur like lawn plant, like it's a repaint.
Okay.
It's a repaint of one of the previous or like a dog, I guess. It's one of the repaints from the blind packs.
Mm-hmm.
Like this is what I was expecting to happen, where they were going to take a lot of those molds and just, I mean, because they're so cheap to manufacture and everything, just repaint them.
Yeah.
And there you got a new character out of it. There's some stuff that's clever, like I said, the pie piece. There's some stuff that's brand new molds or remolds, like the roller pin or the mixer. But in general, I get a feeling we're going to get a lot more of these straight up repaints. I know, and I can understand it. I mean, they want to get the most out of these, but it's going to get to a point that like Hasbro said, like there's going to be like, I think 102 of these. So there's going to be like, and we've only seen like a handful. I think we've only seen like a quarter of that.
Right.
And this is going to be pretty bananas as a completist. It's something that I'm saying to myself, like, I'm not going to, like, I've, up to this point, I've pretty much got almost everything BotBots that is available in retail. But now that I'm seeing how it's going to be handled now, like, for this wave, if you will, where I'm going to end up with a handful of doubles, like, and I mean, like, just to get this complete
set. Your side does not sound like a handful of doubles.
Yeah,
it sounds
see,
like
The problem
five.
Is, yeah, the problem, yeah, it looks
five
like I'm going to...
big palms.
I'm not going to get doubles. I'm not going to get triples. I'm going to get quadruples, you know, and what are they called? Quints at this point? I don't know what's for...
probably.
Sectuplets? I don't know.
That's six.
Yeah. The point is that, like, I'm going to end up with a lot of extras, and the thing is that when you have that idea of doubles, it's because everyone has their own unique doubles and you want to trade, but in this scenario, everyone's going to end up with the same doubles. So who's going to want to trade if you all have the same doubles? And already that's kind of a problem that BotBots is hitting already right now, is that a lot of their multi-packs where you could only get specific characters and you have to end up with doubles, you end up with the same doubles that everyone else. They would all encounter the same problem, pretty much.
Right.
So it's and again, you look at this assortment here, and it's the same thing. Like, each assortment has the one unique one, and then you end up with all the same characters for the other. And of course, that blind character, you know, the mystery character, or the lost bots, as they call it. We don't know what that is, but it's probably going to tie into the same issue where you're going to end up with a bunch of stuff that you don't need, or stuff that you already have. So. Still pretty cool. It's good to see the creative juices that are happening here. But at the same time, I kind of hope they have a better way to do this. I mean, again, I think this comes from my ignorance of how Shopkins is handled and how Grocery Gang is handled, where I don't think anyone really goes into it too much from a completist standpoint without driving themselves crazy. So I'm pretty sure it's just us tackling that collectible environment for the first time as Transformer fans.
Right.
I mean, we've never really had blind pack stuff on that mass a scale. So I don't know. It's something difficult, but I'm really curious how the secondary market's going to be. It's one of those things that when TFCon's going to roll around, I'm going to be really curious how many loose figures of this and little baggies are going to be kicking around and how much people are going to be asking for them. Because I kind of already checked online on eBay, and yeah, people are asking between $3 and $4 average per figure for loose individual ones. But obviously there's some that are worth more than others, which are like the ones that are tougher to get, where right. You have to spend more, and those go between like $6 to $7. But that's now at the peak, you know, that's when it's hot new product. Now I'm kind of curious what's going to happen when it's not the hot new product. Kind of like, I wonder what people are asking for Tiny Titans right now or stuff like that. Like, people are probably just getting rid of them for $1 a piece. So either way, pretty cool. Check it out. Some new characters.